Now, following is a revelation by Action TV into the dealings of the General Secretary of the United National Party, Akhila Viraj Karyavasam. Tarusha joins us with the details.
Good evening. The government, after coming into power in 2015, boasted about many things and made many promises. And some things they promised were those the people never expected or dreamed of. One fine example of such is the provision of tabs for school students and teachers. Rather than distributing the tabs to all school children in the country, the president intervened and it was decided to launch this as a pilot project and to provide tabs to selected schools. However, the Minister of Education did something completely unexpected, as I have mentioned earlier. The final decision reached by the president was to launch this as a pilot project and to upgrade the specifications of these tabs. But the problem is, when you upgrade technical equipment such as these tabs, new tenders need to be called for again. But without doing that, the Minister of Education decides to stick to the tenders called for back in 2017 and go ahead with the seller of their choosing. Now, speaking of textbooks, we come to another interesting juncture here. It is the same Minister, Akhila Viraj Karyavasam, who prints his colour photograph on these textbooks given to school children. Isn't this a bad example for school children who are budding leaders of this country, who are waiting to take up the future of this country? The minister is now asking for 55 million rupees for publicity purposes. The reasons behind this request are quite surprising. Basically, he is asking for 55 million rupees to educate children on what tab computers are, basically, and to explain the importance of using it, and is seeking funding before the end of the school term. The Minister of Education has already selected three companies called for the tenders in order to start this publicity campaign. They have already decided to call for tenders and select a company according to their own whims and fancies, rather than selecting the lowest bidder. There were two bidders, one at 70 million rupees and one for 55 million rupees. Now, 55 million rupees might seem as fair against the 70 million, but let's see who is going to carry out a publicity campaign for tab computers to be distributed for school children for 55 million rupees. We here at News First attempted to research on this particular company, but our efforts were proven futile as the company was nowhere to be found on the internet. But time and time again, we have revealed, we have emphasized how corruption is involved in this endeavor. Minister of Education does not possess the faintest idea as to what the school children can do once these tabs reach their hands. This was confirmed by the cabinet paper requesting for learning content. Now, isn't this an attempt to sell or privatize free education in Sri Lanka? Forming syllabuses, training teachers are done by the National Institute of Education. According to this cabinet paper, the learning content recommended by the National Institute of Education must be purchased. Where can the content recommended by the National Institute of Education be found? The price of a tab is at 27,000 rupees. But the ministry asks for 308 million rupees for 96,919 tabs. When you do the math, the price of a tab has increased from 30,000 rupees, something which seriously raises concerns. Another 350 million, the cost to set up the electronic systems to charge these tabs, is to be given to the same company undertaking the publicity campaign. This can be termed as a large financial fraud by the Ministry of Education, and some of the schools selected for the pilot project do not even have electricity or a power supply. Next comes the distribution of the vouchers for school uniforms, another failed achievement of the good governance government which was elected in 2015, which they claimed was to put an end to corruption. The chief accountant of the Ministry of Education, testifying before the Presidential Commission last week, accepted a malfeasance to the tune of 450 million rupees had occurred last year alone by providing these vouchers. Several institutions were branded as the most corrupt, and it seemed the Ministry of Education is about to join that list.